What's up, guys? This is Nock V, and a couple of hours after I had uploaded the Making of Against the World, I got a really, really good question or request from Russell the Pumpkin. He says, "If you have time, could you please make a video covering vocal sampling? For example, I really like the stuff you did in Sukaru and your remix of Hey Teacher. It's a popular sound in J-Call with all the anime remixing that goes on, but I have no idea how producers do it, and there weren't any good tutorials last time I checked. Thanks a lot for making the whatever." It's a really, really good topic. There's specifically in J-Core that I found there's a different way you go about things when it comes to vocals. This doesn't really apply to Tsukuru or Hey Teacher. Hey Teacher, I had the a cappella given to me from FTFX through a guy named Lemfec, who runs or ran the now defunct Ramen Records. With Sukaru, there was no a cappella and there was no way for me to get the a cappella. So what you hear in Sukaru is really just like a equalized version of the track itself. Pretty dirty. But with a lot of Japanese pop songs, they often come with the instrumental version, or sometimes it's called the off vocal version. And you can use this in conjunction with the original track and actually sort of cancel the instrumental out of the original and just leave the vocals, leaving you with a sort of a pseudo a cappella. This doesn't always work because sometimes due to the mastering process, because the vocals are missing from one, the volume and dynamics are slightly different and it sort of doesn't allow them to cancel each other out as much as you might want, so you get these distortion effects where you hear some of the instruments still a little bit in there. It's not perfect, but usually it's good enough to work with. So before I talk about vocal slicing and how to sort of do some glitchy kind of stuff, what I'll do is I'll go through the a cappella extraction because it's pretty useful to know. Okay, so this is the vocal I started working with. Well, not vocal, but the track. I heard, I think, was it Shingo DJ or something? Did a remix of this, and I heard it, and I'm like, I want to do that as well. I never got around to actually doing it, but. So, what I did is I grabbed the a cappella and. I keep saying a cappella. So, I grabbed the off vocal slash instrumental version. And the original. So this is the original. Vocals, everything in it. And this is the instrumental. Self-explanatory, right? Cool. So I'm just going to drag these into Audacity. I don't do this in FL. I sort of do this in Audacity. It's pretty easy. It's you don't need FL to do this. So we've got the instrumental lined up with the original, and you invert one. So you go to effects and invert, select all of it, go to effects and invert. Now these are always, almost always, they're going to be sort of off. So you use the moving tool to sort of line them up. And you see the bottom one is actually inverted with the top one. So realistically, when you mix those, it should be silence, except for the parts that have vocals in them. And that's essentially the principle of how this works. And so you see, I've lined them all up together. I'm just going to reduce the volume on both of them just in case there is some changes. And you can see it. You can barely even hear it. So it just occurred to me that the reason why some of the kick drum and some distortion is coming through even after the inversion is because I'm using an MP3 version of the song. And MP3s being a lossy kind of codec, meaning they're not perfect quality as was pressed to the CD, like something like a WAV or a FLAC file would be, that causes the samples to be a little bit different. And when you're doing this inversion, the fact that the samples are a little bit different can cause these kind of effects to come through. So if you do want to do this, you can use an MP3, but you might get some crappy sound. But to get absolute perfect quality in an a cappella inversion, use a FLAC file or a WAV file. So you do hear some sort of distortion, and also you hear the kick drum or whatever that is coming through loud as day. So like I said, unfortunately, it's not a whole lot you can do. But usually it's good enough to do a remix with. So that's what it sounds normally. So I'm just going to export this out, and it'll tell you that it's going to mix it down, and that's exactly what you want. You want it to be mixed together. Cool. Give that, just chuck that onto an effects channel, and that kick drum can sort of be equalized out, so I can sort of see it in the EQ, so I just take that down, get rid of some of the high end hiss as well that sort of comes from the distortion. I'll get that up to 175. And also, this track isn't 175 BPM. So what I'm going to be talking about is time stretching the vocal so that it matches 175 BPM. Obviously, you can hear that the head does not sound like 175 BPM, and it's getting all over the place. So what I do is I usually go to this JavaScript tap BPM. So I Google that, and yeah, there it is, the first one. So what I'll do is I'll play the track and also tap along with the track. And this thing will sort of give you an approximation of what the BPM actually is. Usually things are like square on like 180 or 170 or 140, but this one's on 182. It's generally a good idea to go off the nearest hole. So what we do is we click there, go to fit to tempo, then go to type in BPM and type in the BPM you just found, 182. This is going to go ahead and take a while and stretch it out because it's a longer sound file, so it takes a little while to stretch. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to line up a part of it with the kick drum and hear how this sounds. I'll turn the kick back on. And as you can hear, that sounds pretty much spot on. Okay, so now with the vocal slicing, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start cutting out little bits of the vocals. What I do is I'm pressing C to go into the chopping mode, and I'm dragging down along the sound clip to sort of make a little cut in it. So you can see here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to find that little bit and drag down in those two sections and just click on it once so that I can, when I click again, it's going to place it there. So I'm pressing C to go into chopping mode, and then I'll press E to go back into placing mode, or whatever they're actually called. I press E, click on it, then place it over there. So I'm just going through and I'm looking for little bits to take. So I'll get different tonalities, because before it was a little bit monotonous, so I'll get this different note that the singer sings, and I'll place that down. You can already see hear it coming together.
Okay.
I'm taking a little bit of a smaller chunk here. I intended on making it a bit stuttery, but the way I had painted it didn't really come out that way. So that's the basic of what I ended up with, but I also thought of doing some sort of tone manipulation to it using pitcher. Get to that in a little bit. Also, you can see I'm sort of pressing C to go into the cutting mode, because you see the cursor change. That pressing C in the playlist won't work unless you have the keyboard turned off, the sort of keyboard MIDI emulation stuff. So what I'm doing is I'm loading up pitcher onto it, and I'll turn it into MIDI and octave mode. What I'm going to want to do is get a MIDI out, chuck the port on the same port that I set the pitcher to. So you could also see that I changed the port that the MIDI, the pitcher was on. So when I play a note on here, it sort of forces the vocals to be on that tone. It's not perfect, but it makes some cool kind of glitchy sounds. So what I'll make is a little pattern for the tune or the MIDI notes that I'm going to be putting down. And I'm not going to put down too much. It's probably just going to be in the second bit. I'm just going to do like two notes. I'm going to draw that out where I want it to be. Just there. And one more just up there. And put a delay on there. Get some echo. Oops, put it on the wrong place. Trying to think of some stuttering that I'm going to put on it. Nothing really sounds too good. So at this point I've conceded that Gross Beat's not going to do too much for me. However, I will turn it on for the very last bit. So I chuck a automation clip on the volume of what Gross Beat's doing. So on the very last two bars, it's Gross Beat's turned on there. So what I'm going to be doing now is just adding some bass and some stuff to make this sound like an actual song. I'm going to skip through most of this because I guess it's not really part of the video. And besides, me making this bass sounds crap for a long time before it starts sounding good. This was horrible. So I'm just going to go through and add percussion as I did in the last video too. And also get a little tune over the top as well. that really sums up working with Japanese vocals and doing vocal slicing. So we covered a cappella extraction from when you have the original and an instrumental using Audacity. And then there was time stretching that out so it fits whatever BPM you're using by finding the BPM using a JavaScript tap thing on the internet. And then there's also cutting those vocals up and slicing them however which way you want. And then arranging that into a little bit of a UK hardcore kind of thing. Also using pitcher to do some tonal manipulation on that, and then gross beat to do some stuttering as well. So I hope this video has been helpful. Once again, if you have any questions or want to point out something stupid that I'm doing, go right ahead. And if you have any more requests, let me know in the comments. I'll see and try to do what I can. And see you guys in the next video.